Why do you still fight on? Maybe you too should suffer with your brethren in this rot and let your blood seep into the seas of the rivers of hell. Isn't that what you deserve after all you've done? Give the darkness what it wants, let it swallow your soul and destroy all that you are. Why are you fighting for someone who's already dead? Just look around you. What hope is there for him, even if his soul could be rescued? Do you think he would thank you for what you have done to him, to his friends, to his father?
A lot of fighting, but a lot of bunch of arms. We're here to save Senu and, or not Senu, but our mother Galena and our lover.
I can't fight it anymore. Not on my own. Where are you, Mother? To be with you.
That night, she gave up on her world to follow in the footsteps of her mother, to go to a place where the darkness couldn't reach her.
Senua, look at me.
Do you hear them? They're calling for me.
We've lost so many. And I've lost my father. I can't lose you.
You said it. I have blood on my hands.
I didn't say that. You've done nothing wrong. Zimbal is a fake. He is a hateful, bitter liar. He's poison. And his words still haunt you. Who do you trust? Him? Or me? Do you still believe in me, Senua? In us? Come back to me. Please. Don't let this darkness come between us.
Hardest battles are fought in the mind. He gave her the sword with which to fight in more ways than one. And she gave him her word never to surrender. All she needed was a little help. A little hope.
I go poke back at this tree real quick. I don't think there's a story thing up there. I was thinking maybe it's inside the tree there. More likely it's on the way back. Oh my god, it's a new sword. Pretty good looking sword, too.
Into the mountain.
Can you see it?
Shall we tell her where to go?
It's far. Go on.
Look up.
Just up there.
Listen to us.
Sit.
Shall we tell her where to go?
Shall we?
Does she know which way to look? Does she know her way into the mountain?
She's a good girl.
Oh, isn't she? There's a door.
You can do it.
You can see it.
Come on, Senua.
Go away. I'm not listening.
Just checking for story bits. Yeah, see that R one we missed, and I don't know where. That was that whole beach area.
I will tell you of a great hero named Sigurd, son of Sigmund, no less. Born after his father's death, Sigurd is cared for by the dwarf Rein. But Rein does not love the boy. Instead, he plans to use him for his own ends. You see, Rein's father possessed a great treasure given to him by the gods. But Rein's brother, Fafnir, killed his father and took the gold all for himself. Fafnir hid the treasure out on a heath and could not leave it. And from the evil in his heart, he turned into a dark creature. A dragon.
Okay.
Thank you.
We're gonna have to fight a dragon next.
She can feel it.
No.
Don't open the door.
No, go in. Don't turn back.
What's it like?
Get back! A great beast guards Helheim. Garm is its name. And it knows you are here, Senua. It can smell your stink. What are you afraid of, Senua? How would you say Dillion if you are too much of a coward to step into the shadows?
They can't stop me.
Then do it.
We were supposed to run, okay.
Useless here. Don't fall for it.
It's me, Senua. It's
so loud.
It's not her.
So full of hate.
It's a trap.
I just want to help them. Tell me what to do. Your father wants them to go away. And he only hurts me to silence them. But he's gone now.
But they always come back. He says I will die if I go with them. You want me with them?
Stop!
That's why they crawl through the walls.
Don't listen.
Do you
to them.
See them?
Do you see their faces? He's coming! Senua! Help me! Help! Get me out of here! Don't go!
Where has she gone? She's disappeared again.
She shouldn't be here. She escaped the darkness. She took her own life to escape it.
She can't remember when it started. When her mother lost her smile. Her eyes gazing past her towards a world she could not see. This is what happens if you reach for the underworld, he said. It was a lot to take in for a child. And the first time she felt the cold. Chill. Fear. I don't talk much about her father. Zinbel. I suppose I just didn't want to risk upsetting her. But it doesn't matter now, does it?
Her torch is going out.
No, it's not. It's gonna run out soon.
She hasn't got much time.
It's gonna burn out.
And she's too slow.
It's not going to burn out.
The darkness will come again.
Keep going. What's next? Do you want to find? Do you want to find? Why? Do you want to find? Why? Do you want to find?
She'll have to go under.
She can't.
She has to.
She can't.
The torch will go out.
Don't. Let the torch go out.
There's light in the distance.
She can do it. She can't do it.
The light's gone out. Run, Nick. Get through it as quick as you can. The panic is here.
What was that?
Reminds her of the isolating, suffocating darkness that she lived through as a young girl. Imprisoned in her room at night, the faces in the dark coming through the walls. She once thought everyone could see them. I mean, that's what children say all the time, isn't it? That there are monsters in the dark. By the time she realized that only she could see them, her father, Bell, could see the monster in her.
Rain the dwarf's sole desire is to possess this dragon's accursed treasure, and he uses Sigurd to reclaim it. He tells Sigurd the story of Fafnir's gold, and the good-hearted hero promises to slay the dragon if Rhaen would forge a strong sword for him. Sigurd remembers that his father once possessed a sword given to him by Odin. Odin broke the sword to bring about Sigmund's death, but Sigurd's mother still has the pieces. And so Rhaen reforges the famous sword. Sigurd uses the sword first to avenge his father, and then he and Rhaen go in search of Fafnir.
Thank you.
can't go anywhere without the light.
Take the torch and move.
I don't remember. I was only five. They told me she escaped the darkness, that she's with the gods. But what if they lied? What if the darkness took her and trapped her here?
It's a trap. The beast is coming. Stupid little thing.
Spreading. Father's keeping me away from the others. Away from Tilly. I won't give up. I'm not going to rot in here.
Pretty sure we had to go down anyways, so we're obviously not gonna do an Assassin's Creed style jump down there. It's like a gate to where we were supposed to go anyway, so.
Don't give up.
Yeah!
And clearly the maybe a light we're supposed to put up there. Ah, yeah. Endure.